Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana, and we're working on a series of videos here called Assistive Technology Then and Now. I've got a collection of old technology that I've kind of collected over the years, and I want to show you guys some things that were the older technology and have given way to newer technology. Today we're going to play with toys. And what I have here are a couple of devices that we actually made here at Easter Seals Crossroads, or modified here at Crossroads many, many years ago. And this is an old Fisher-Price wind-up radio kind of toy, but it had a small knob on it that was hard for a kid, and I think in this particular situation the child had cerebral palsy, was hard for them to get a hold of that little knob. So basically, one of our therapists at that point took a piece of wood and made a bigger, easier to hang on to knob so that a kid with limited mobility could get a hold of this toy and play with it like that. So that was one modification. The next one was an early switch modification. This happened probably in the late 80s. This is a bicycle musical horn that goes on your regular old bike, and normally you would push this button on the handlebar of your bike. Well, this was brought in-house so that a kid, again with cerebral palsy, could grab a hold of the switch, stabilize, and then use a hand grip or a thumb press or whatever to access it and then make the music play. And I guess the batteries must be dead on this guy because he's not doing, oh, there he goes. So the batteries are dying on that. But these are two examples of homemade adaptive toys that were done here. Now today there are still lots and lots of toys that are out there, but we've got what here is another modified toy. This is actually a pig that has had a switch interrupter put in it. But what happens is when you do a switch interrupter, it gives you a jack like this, and then you can hook a switch to it. So now instead of having to wrap my hand around a wooden piece of dowel over there and pushing a button, I can hook this switch up and make the pig go. But the real important thing in the development is this is a fairly generic switch interface. So I've got a box here with literally dozens, and we have hundreds of different kinds of switches that can make it go. So I've gone from a series of toys that are very specific for one kid that only have one interface that will work to a different toy that I can play with lots and lots and lots of different kinds of switches that I can hook up and make work. And we literally have dozens and dozens of these kind of things. So again, I'm just dragging some things out of our Museum of Assistive Technology for a little bit of assistive technology then and now. So I'm Wade Wingler, and that's your tech tip for this week at the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.